Tonight, a celebration of music and friendship on The Arlo Guthrie Show.
Welcome to The Arlo Guthrie Show. This is Arlo Guthrie. Him. This is me personally speaking to you through your TV right now. So I want to tell you right now that for the next 2 hours, you're going to hear some of the most fantastic music. I'm talking about music from Pete Seeger. Music from Bonnie Raitt, Jerry Jeff Walker, David Bromberg, and myself. We're going to be playing and singing together for the next 2 hours. So don't go anywhere. Sit right down. Enjoy yourself. Here we go.
Thank you.
let this garden grow. Gonna mulch it deep and low. Gonna make it fertile ground. Inch by inch, row by row. Please bless these seeds I sow. Please keep them safe below till the rain comes tumbling down. Pulling weeds and picking stones. We are made of dreams and bones. Need a place to call my own, 'cause the time is close at hand. Green for green, sun and rain. Find my way in nature's chain. Tune my body and my brain to the music of the land. Sing along, you know. Inch by inch, row by row. Gonna make this garden grow. Gonna mulch it deep and low. Gonna make it fertile ground. Inch by inch, row by row. Please bless these seeds I sow. Please keep them safe below till the rain comes tumbling down. Plant your rows straight and long. It's season with a prayer and song. Mother Earth will make you strong if you give her love and care. Old crow watching from a tree, he's got his hungry eye on me. But in my garden I'm as free as that feathered thief up there. Inch by inch, row by row, gonna make this garden grow. Gonna mulch it deep and low. Gonna make it fertile. Inch by inch, row by row.
Inch by inch, row by row. Please bless me.
Okay, okay, okay. Hold this. I know this is TV and stuff. You're not supposed to stop the song, but let me tell you, that's not good. You got to sing on this stuff. I know you're sitting out there saying, look, I don't want people to be seeing me sing on TV. People at home. I know you don't want to see yourself. That's worse. I know. But hey, this is the truth now. I mean, I used to, and not only, you probably, I know what it really is. You're sitting there saying, look, why should I be singing along on that Dingleberry folk song anyway? I used to feel this way about a song. I learned a song from Pete Seeger. And Pete'd be up singing it, and everybody'd be singing along, and I'd just be in the back going, fantastic. I wouldn't be caught dead singing this song. I thought this was, and I felt that way for a long time, even up until, I don't know, this morning. Actually, it was last week when I first began to change my mind, because last week, by accident, I happened to be up in Canada, and I was coming back down across the border, and they stopped me at the Canadian Customs and Immigration. They stopped me going out. I could see stopping me coming in, you know, but I don't know. I guess if you look like me now, they stop you no matter which way you're going. So anyway, I was up there, and I was stopped, and they were going through my papers behind the glass booth, and I was the only one stopped. Everybody else was, sure, go right on ahead. And it was like late at night. I was sitting there alone. And while I was sitting in there waiting, just by accident, I happened to be singing this song to myself. You know, like, I don't know, it just came to me. Inch by inch, row by row, gonna make this garden grow, oh yeah. And all of a sudden, a guy come flying out the booth. He tapped me on the shoulder and said, excuse me, sir, but what's that you're doing, eh? I looked at the guy, I said, hey, I'm singing a song. He said, I know that, sir, but what language is that song in? I said, what language? It's in American! And I looked at the guy, and he had a puzzled face on, like a quizzled face, you know? And I looked at him, and I suddenly realized this guy was about 20 years old, was probably just out of school, and this was his first job, and he didn't know what an inch was. I suddenly realized this was no Dingleberry folk song I was singing. I suddenly realized this song was significant. This song was about something. This song was about the last spot, about the last bastion, about the last place where we still have the poetry of mile after mile in our lives and not kilometer after kilometer. I suddenly knew this song was no just Dingleberry folk song. I knew this song was significant. It was about a way of life just rapidly disappearing from the entire planet and maybe even the whole universe. I suddenly realized there's a new way of life sneaking in, screwing us up. Sneaking in when you got to buy pop bottles and plastic liters now. You got to buy gas the same way in some places. They say it's cheap now. How do you know? Sneaking in when kids come home from school doing homework and you don't even know it's math they're doing. Sneaking in, screwing up our way of life. It doesn't take too much. I mean, everybody in the world, every country in the world used to have their own way of counting years ago. Look what's happened to the world now that everybody's going to this new stuff. Screwed up. And that's being kind and generous. And that's being on TV. You know what I'm talking about. And it's beginning to happen here in America. And people are saying, how come it's getting screwed up here in America? And so the Congress got committees, president got commission, everybody wants to know, nobody asked me, and I know. I know, because I know stuff. I sing about stuff. I sing about a lot of important things sometimes. But there's nothing more important than this song. So I want you to sing along, because it should be obvious now to everyone around the world that the problems of the world can't be solved in meters. The problems of the world can only be solved the way we made them, inch by inch and mile after mile. So here we go now. Don't be clapping and stuff. You got to sing along, inch by inch. Okay, here we go. Song. I know some people are trying to sing now, and there's other people sitting back there saying, I don't care. I don't care if that song could save the world. I'm not going to sing that song. Because I hate gardens. And I hate songs about them. I know there's people that feel like that in the world. And a lot of them moved to Austin, Texas. And they're all here at the show right now. People who hate gardens. I can feel it out there. I know what I'm talking about. And if you feel like it, this is a verse for you. Somebody gave me this the other day because they hated gardens too, and they weren't going to sing on this song, so maybe it'll be an inspiration for you. I know everybody needs different kind of inspiration in the world. So here we go. I just have to remember it. It's hard sometimes to remember. Let's see. It goes up. Slug by slug, weed by weed, boy, this garden's got me teed. All the insects come to feed in my tomato plants. Sunburned face, skinned up knees. I hate this next line. The kitchen's choked with zucchinis. Shopping at the A&P's next time I get a chance. To the 60s generation. All that junk like peace and love is just an aggravation. Ain't got no use for transcendental meditation. Been a Virgo or a head shop owner or two freaks from San Francisco or a washed out surfer with his body golden tan or some lead singer in a psychedelic band feeding me granola stuff. You told me meat was our style, but I just can't get enough. Being vegetarian just ain't quite my scene. There's only so much you can do with soybeans, Mom. You universal love is such a drain. You know, Mom keeps telling me about her days at Woodstock. Baseballs and all of them with their feet stuck, freaking out on acid and what Bob Dylan says. I think she's trying to turn me into Joan Baez. Well, Mom, can't you tell me where your head's at? I'm sick to death of hearing about where you saw the Grateful Dead's at. This generation, all that junk like peace and love is just an aggravation. Ain't got no use for transcendental meditation. Your universal love is such a trend. He fought for the people of Chile with his songs and his guitar. His hands were gentle, his hands were strong. Victor Jara was a peasant, worked from a few years old. He sat upon his father's plow and watched the earth unfold. His hands were gentle, his hands were strong. Now when the neighbors had a wedding, oh, one of their children died. His mother sang all night for them with Victor by her side. His hands were gentle, his hands were strong. He grew up to be a fighter against the people's wrongs. He listened to their grief and joys and turned them into songs. His hands were gentle, his hands were strong. He sang about the copper miners and those who worked the land. He sang about the factory workers, and they knew he was their man. His hands were gentle, his hands were strong. Then the generals seized Chile, they arrested Victor then. They caged him in a stadium with 5,000 frightened men. His hands were gentle, his hands were strong. Victor stood in the stadium, and his voice was brave and strong. And he sang for his fellow prisoners till the guards cut short his song. His hands were gentle, his hands were strong.
They broke the bones in both his hands. They beat him on the head. They tore him with electric shocks. And then they shot him dead. His hands were gentle. His hands were strong. Victor Hara of Chile lived like a shooting star. He fought for the people of Chile with his songs and his guitar. His hands were gentle. His hands were strong. His hands were gentle. His hands were strong.
Don't go away. We'll be right back with songs from Jerry Jeff Walker, Bonnie Raitt, David Bromberg, and Pete Seeger. Back to the Arlo Guthrie Show with Jerry Jeff Walker, Bonnie Raitt, David Bromberg, and Pete Seeger. Back to you, Arlo.
20 years ago in a small radio station, WBAI, in New York City, I played Alice's Restaurant for the first time on the air. And sitting right across from me was a friend of mine by the name of Jerry Jeff Walker singing a new song of his own. And he was accompanied by another friend of mine, David Bromberg. And here they are again.
I do a mambo tangles and he dance for you. Worn out shoes, silver hair, a ragged shirt and baggy pants. Did the old sunshine jump so high, jump so high, and he lightly touched down. He laughed, slapped his legs still. Said the name Bojangles and he danced a lick across the cell. He grabbed his pants, a better stance, and then he jumped up high. He clicked his heels. He let go a laugh. He let go a laugh. Back his clothes all around. Tears, 15 years, I was dogging him, traveled and bound, sent his dog up and down, city up and down. After 20 years, he still grieves. Said I dance at every chance in honky tonks, for drinks and tips. Most of the time I spend behind these county bars. A lot of drinks and beer. He shook his head. As he shook his head, I heard someone ask him, please. sing the man Bojangles and he just dance for you.
Bonnie Raitt started out playing and singing around the same time that I did. I've always admired her as a singer and as a guitar player, and over the years that I've come to know her, as a wonderful human being as well. She's crazy, she's wonderful, she's fantastic. This is Bonnie Raitt.
They all said Louise was not half bad. It was written on the walls and window shades, and how she'd act the little girl. The deceiver, don't believe her, that's her trade.
I've known David Bromberg for over 20 years. It's only been recently in the last 3 or 4 years that we've played a lot together. We've been touring the country together and having a wonderful time. He's a great musician. He's a great writer and singer. And here he is, David Bromberg.
Testify about my love. I want to testify about my love. I gotta testify about my love for you. Hey, I've got a lover who stays right by my side. No matter what the world throws my way. And all that I want out of this life is to keep that one person satisfied. Because it's right by my side. I want her to stay. Yes, and if I come home late in the evening or the middle of the night, I know I'll find her there. But wherever I go, whatever I do in this wide world, she'll always care. Now I want to testify.
Testify about my love.
I want to testify.
Testify about my love.
Hey, I gotta testify.
Testify about my love.
My love for you. It's in that father thing. I'll be your father.
Father.
I'll be your brother.
Brother.
I'll be your baby.
Baby.
Your sweet midnight lover.
Lover.
I got to testify about my love. My love for you. Say I testify.
Testify.
When I wrote, I said I just wrote the tune, you know, when I wrote it. When I wrote it, it was right, you know. I had the good thing that everybody wants to have. But I was dumb enough to blow it, so I had to write a new verse. I may as well sing the truth. I'm gonna sing the verse right now. I'm in love with a woman, people, and she once loved me. But now I'm just one of her toys. It's my own fault, and even a fool could see how bad it hurts me inside to know I'm just one of the boys. Hey, but that's a pain that I can deal with if it's what I have to do to stay near her and part of her life. To testify.
Testify about my love.
Hey, I gotta testify.
Testify about my love.
Did you ever hear anybody say that love is power? Did you ever hear anybody say that?
Testify.
I say, did you ever hear anybody say love is power? That's the truth. Love is power. You never heard it before. You're hearing it right now. Love is power. That's the truth. Did you ever hear anybody say that power corrupts? I had this girl's love and I felt the power. It made me feel strong. I couldn't leave it alone. I had to play with it. You know, like she wanted a little loving sometime. A man could tell. She don't have to say nothing. I wouldn't give it to her, you know. Make her want me more, you know. And then I'd go out and I'd play around with other women. I wouldn't hide it either. I'd come home with lipstick all over my shirt like she's supposed to wash it or something, you know. You know, she wasn't about to take that. She came to me one day, she said, David, you can't be like that. I said, you don't own me. Does anybody here ever said or heard that one? You don't own me. That's some dumb stuff, that you don't own me stuff, I'll tell you right now. She looked at me, she just said one word, you know, just one word. She looked at me, she go, right. That's all she said, you know. That ain't all she did, you know. She started stepping out on me, you know. She found out a few things. She found out she could find men a lot easier than I could find women, you know. She found out something else, too. She found out she didn't need my ugly face around the apartment no more. I come home one night, find everything I own in brown Safeway bags outside the door. I'm history, you understand what I'm saying? I was a fool, and I'm not ashamed to admit it. I'll tell you right now. And I want you to know, for all I know, the girls out there, listen, she probably turned on the TV and see me, you know. She'd be with some man, she'd be poking the guy. She'd be saying, look at that fool up there begging for what I'm sitting on, you know? Listen, if you'll listen to me, this is a chance for me to talk to you. If you are listening to me, I would do anything in the world to get back together with you again. I would say anything, do anything, hear anything. I would give everything I own and a lot I don't own just to start one more time. And I wouldn't play no games this time. This time you look for me, you find me. I don't mean to say that you have to say me. You don't even have to visualize my face. All you have to do, just begin to think about me one time. Just think about me and I'll be there. This time I will be there for you. I don't care what hour or day or night is, I'll be there. In the wee midnight hour, I'll be there. Early in the morning, I'll be there. Like the Rocky Ages, I'll be there. Like the Rocky Mountains, I'll be there. Like the sun in the sky, I'll be there. Like Captain Planet, I'll be there. And I don't care how heavy your fight may be. I don't care what you want, what you want to do, what you want to say. I don't care what you need a man for. I don't care what you use, you might have or I need. I don't care, just as long as you use me, baby, just use me. Just use me, use me, use me. You want a hand to hold, use me. You want a shoulder to cry, use me. You want an ear to tell your troubles to, use me. You want a body to bed beside your night, use me. I want to testify about my love. Testify about my love. I gotta testify
about my love.
My love for you. Oh, well.
You know, it hasn't always been fashionable or even popular for normal, everyday people to get up and sing songs like you're hearing tonight. It took a few people a few years ago to begin that process, and now it's turned into a whole way of living and a whole way of doing things. And a large part of that, a large part of what's going on, we can thank Pete Seeger for.
I was born along the banks of the Hudson River and hope to live there till I die. I'm very proud to have been a part of an extraordinary movement during the last 20 years that started to clean up the river. 20 years ago, there were lumps of this and that floating by with the toilet paper. But today we're swimming again in the middle part, and another 5 or 10 years, we should be swimming near New York. Part of the reason for it is an extraordinary sailboat that a bunch of people built. Raised money for 3 years and built a replica of the old cargo boats that used to carry lumber and bricks. They had hundreds of them on the river back in the 19th century, and we built this river and had a vote to call it Clearwater. Of course, water wasn't that clear when we started sailing, but as I said, it's getting clearer. And the way we do it, it's kind of a soft sell. We stop in at a town and say, let's have a festival right on the dirty old riverbank. And we have music and food and a little education and propaganda too. And this is just one of the many Clearwater songs. It was some new words put to one of Jimmy Reed's blues tunes by one of the Clearwater singers, Laurie Wyatt. You have to help me. I sing sailing up, and you gotta repeat it. Sailing up, sailing down, sailing down. After that, you have to reverse it. You don't always have to agree with me. If I say up, you say down. Sailing up, sailing down, up, down, up and down the river, sailing on, stopping all along the way. The river may be dirty now, but she's getting cleaner every day. Singing here, singing there, here, there, up and down the river, sailing on, stopping all along. She's getting cleaner every day. Catching fish, catching hell, hell, fish, up and down the river, sailing on, stopping all along the way. The river may be dirty now, but she's getting cleaner every day. The river may be dirty now, but she's getting cleaner every day. One more time. The river may be dirty now, but she's getting cleaner every day.
Don't do nothing. Don't touch your TV. Don't stand up. Just hang on. We'll be right back with more Pete Seeger and Bonnie Raitt, David Bromberg, Jerry Jeff Walker, and me even, Arlo Guthrie. We'll see you in just a few minutes, so hang right in there.
Here we go with more of the Arlo Guthrie Show. Back in the spotlight this time is the star of the show, Arlo.
Every morning, just as soon as it's light, get out of bed, you know I'm feeling alright. Make me some coffee, sit down alone, the rest of the day I'm on a telephone. Hang up, hold on, you got a dime, so you come on.
One in the car, and I got one in the yard. A phone on my saddle for when
phone in my pocket for when I'm down at the Grange. Hang up, hold on, you got a dime, so you come on so strong. Save your money and let me be. Hang up the phone and pray and find your enemy. Devaluation all over the land. You know, the whole wide world's got more money in their hand. They've been calling me up from Peking and Nome. I'm gonna rip out this telephone. Hang up, hold on. You got a dime, so you come on so strong. Save your money and let me be. Hang up your phone.
Now, once again, the big man from Chicago, David Bromberg.
All right.
Okay.
Well, never hit 17 when you play against the dealer, because you know the odds won't ride with you. And never leave your woman alone with friends around to steal her, use her gambles. Lost like summer waves, yeah. So we'll just keep rolling on until we get to Vancouver, and the woman I love is living there. It's been 6 long months or more since I've seen her. Maybe gambled and lost like summer waves, yeah. And in the hall, the beer parlors all down along Main Street, the dreams of the seasons get spilled down on the floor. All the big stands of timber are ready for falling, and the hustlers sitting watchfully as they wait there at the door. So I'll work on those toes in my slipper city shoes, which I swore I would never do again. Through the great fog bound straits, where the cedars stand watching, I'll be far off, gone like summer waves, yeah. Spill down on the floor. All the big stands of timber are ready for falling, and the hustlers sitting watchfully as they wait there at the door. Oh, she's a woman so fine, I might never try to find her, because good memories are all we had before.
they should never be changed, because they're all that I'll take with me. Now I've gambled, lost my summer wages. Boys never hit 17. When you play against the dealer, cause you know the odds won't ride with you. And never leave your woman alone with friends around who steal her. Years are gambled, lost like summer wages.
Now, back to stage two and the legendary Pete Seeger.
Kids in the streets, I don't know where they learned it, have a kind of music. They don't use a banjo or guitar or anything, just tapping on the hands. You know what? I could teach this to you. All you need, two hands and some knees. Try tapping your hands and stay in rhythm with me. Keep in rhythm no matter what you do. Sometimes tap anywhere you want. Tap, doo, 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 doo. Tap with the other hand. Some mix it up. Hush, little baby, and I don't say a word. Papa gonna buy you a mockingbird. If that mockingbird don't sing, Papa gonna buy you a diamond. If that diamond ring is brass, Papa gonna buy you a looking
glass.
If that looking glass gets broke, Papa gonna buy you a billy. If that billy goat don't pull, Papa gonna buy you a cart and bull. If that cart and bull turn over, Papa gonna buy you a dog named
Rover.
If that dog named Rover don't bark, Papa gonna buy you a horse and
cart.
If that horse and cart fall down, you'll still be the sweetest little baby in. Almost 40 years ago, Lee Hayes wrote some words and I put a tune to it. And the record we made with the Weavers never went anywhere. Lee used to say it was a collector's item. Nobody but collectors got it. But about 8 years later, Peter, Paul, and Mary changed my tune. I always figured I really should pay them royalties because their version of the song just took off and it went all around the world. And anybody here, I hope you're going to clear out your throat and help me sing this song. It'll sound much better if you sing it. If I had the hammer, I hammer in the morning, hammer in the evening, a hammer all over
this land.
Hammer out danger, a hammer out danger,
a hammer out war,
hammer out love,
hammer out love
between the brothers and the sisters. Oh, over this land. If I had a bell,
sing out warning,
I sing out love,
I sing out love,
the brothers and the sisters. Oh,
singer, songwriter, wild man, Jerry Jeff Walker.
Yeah, well, it won't be but a week or two. You'll be out of loving someone new. Seems like it's happened 100 times before. I can see you've been spreading yourself thin too, and it's a lonely stage we've been going through. Well, don't get up, and I can find my own way to the door. And I can see you are an angel, this way she's flown on four. Tune up your harp, polish your old halo. The only kind of man that you ever wanted was the one that you knew you'd never hold very long. Sitting there crying like I'm the first one to go.
All right, first turn around.
You may have 30 lovers behind you, and I can feel, but I sure can't find you. Seems like you would have found your own self by now. Late at night, the thought of lovers' tears come back. Faces in your dream, fingers in your back. The voices of the memory, never crying out loud. All right. And I can see you are an angel. This wing's swan and full. Tune up your heart. Polish your old halo. That I believe I'm leaving, it's getting too deep. Guess it's easy enough for any man to see. Still we never agree if we talked all night. Things are getting heavy, baby, traveling light. Goodbye, jaded lover, you undercover queen for a day. Hey, hey.
Thank you very much.
Now, here is another classic song from Bonnie Raitt.
Nice to be here, Arlo. Cowboy. It weren't much to look at,
just a free rambling man. That was a long time. No matter how I tried, years just flowed by like a broken down dam. Make me an angel that flies from Montgomery. Make me a poster of old rodeo. Just give me one thing I can hold on to believe in this living is just a hard way to go. There's flies in the kitchen. I can hear them there buzzing. And I ain't done nothing since I woke up today. How the hell can a person gonna work in the morning can come home in the evening and have nothing to say? Just a hard way to go.
Don't go away, friends. We'll be right back with the never recorded, never before released, never understood story of Coming into L.A. and more.
And the grand finale of the Arlo Guthrie Show.
Just twist its curfew gold glass upon four-legged forest clouds. The cowboy angel rides with his candle lit into the sun, though its glow is waxed in black. All except beneath the trees of Eden, the lamppost stands with folded arms, its iron claws attached. Two curbs neath holes where babies wail through its shadow's metal badge. All in all, can only fall with a crashing but meaningless blow. No sound ever comes from the gates of Eden. Savage soldier sticks his head into the sand and then complains unto the shoeless hunter who's gone deaf but still remains upon the beach where hound dogs bay at ships with tattooed sails, headed for the gates of Eden. The time rusted compass blade, Latin in his lamp. Sits with utopian hermit monks, science saddle on the golden calf. And on their promises of paradise, you will not hear a laugh. All except inside the gates of Eden. Relationships of ownership, they whisper in the winds. To those condemned, act accordingly, and await for succeeding kings. But I try and harmonize with songs the lonesome sparrow sings. And there are no kings inside the gates of Eden. Motorcycle black Madonna, two-wheel gypsy queen, and a silver-studded phantom caused the gray flannel dwarf to scream. As he weeps, two wicked birds of prey pick up on his breadcrumb sins. And there are no sins inside the gates of Eden. Kingdoms of experience and the precious wind they ride, while paupers change possessions, each one wishing for what the other has got. And the princess and the prince discuss what's real and what's not. It doesn't matter inside the gates of Eden. The foreign sun, it squints upon a bed that is never mine. As friends and others, strangers from their fates try to resign, leaving men wholly and totally free to do anything they wish to do but die. And there are no trials inside the gates of Eden. Dawn, my lover comes to me and tells me of her dreams, with no attempts to shovel a glimpse into the ditch of what each one needs. And at times I think there are no words but these to tell what's true.
We've been on, this tour is like a celebration. This actual show is the end of a tour for us. We've been on the road since back in February. And that's a long time. I don't know when you're watching this thing, if you're watching it on TV, but that's like most of the year ago. Anyway, so we've been on the road for a while, and we didn't get much time off, but a couple of times we got to stay in a few places for a while. And one of the times I remember I was watching TV because they had the cable at the hotel and we don't have it where I live. So I was looking at TV just to see what was on. And I was watching C-SPAN to see what the Congress looked like. Because, you know, remember you could see that thing on TV now. So I was watching the Congress, and it was that time they were debating the war on drugs. And I found that interesting because I wanted to know how it was going to affect me personally. You know, I mean, Not sort of in that way, because I've been good for a long time, but I just wanted to know. And I figured the main difference in my life would be that there'd be, like, more narcs at the shows than ever before, you know? And I figured that'd be a great thing, because it's something I've been waiting to tell them for all these years, and just didn't have a chance to get so many in one place at one time. And because most of them don't realize, especially, like, younger narcs don't realize that I got my start playing music over 20 years ago, mostly due to agents of the federal government. It's true. Because when I started playing, I was playing in these little clubs, And I was the only one there. There was nobody coming to them. I was just playing at them. And I was saying weird things. And I was not the only one. There were other people playing other empty clubs, and they were saying weird things too. And it was about that time the federal government said, let's go find out what those weird people were saying. And so they dressed some people up and disguised them as normal and sent them down to the club. And it was about that time the state government started saying, look, there's people going to those clubs. Let's find out what's going on there. So they disguised some people and sent them down. And by the time we were done with the federal and the state and the local and the county and the city and all that, we was packing these little clubs from coast to coast. And pretty soon, this is true. Pretty soon, tour buses was coming down filled with people saying, my God, there must be something going on over there. Let's go see what it is. And TV executives and record company presidents started coming down, signing up everything they played. And I got swept up along with the rest of them. And I'm still here 20 years later. And I want to say thank you to those guys who had to come down years ago. I know there might be a few of you out here in this audience today. I know you can't be going like this, but hey, it's good to see you out there. And I know it's hard to be a narc, especially today, because, well, people don't realize the work that goes into like being a narc. It's not something, people don't realize the talent and ability you got to have. You know what I'm saying? I mean, it's not like, you don't just get out of high school and say, well, should I go to college or be a narc? You can't do that. You got to have talents and abilities to start when you're a little baby. It's got to be nurtured and growed right. I mean, maybe, most kids lose those abilities around 5 or 6 years old. But in certain cases, when it's growed right, when people is taken care of right, those abilities can linger into adulthood. Maybe it's easier today with special ed and stuff, but these guys didn't have that back then. You know what I'm talking about? These guys had to develop powers and abilities on their own. And I know that, you know, when you think of people with powers, you'd be thinking of some yogi sitting in a cave in India or something, but hey, I know people right here in America that's got powers some of you guys wouldn't believe. Because I met a guy one time, and this guy, this was a little while ago, but I met him, and they used to stick this guy on airport runways, and he would smell airplanes as they was coming in for landing. This is before they knew about dogs. This is true. Not only could he pick out the plane, but he could pick out the seat. He would radio into the guys at the gate saying, there's a man in 36C, he's carrying some illegal substance. And then they'd pick up that poor guy at the gate and he'd be wondering how they knew. I know, I could feel you sitting out there saying, boy, that is the stupidest thing that guy's ever said. What does he know what he's talking about? I know what I'm talking about. Because one time, I was sitting on an airplane in seat 36C. I was coming into America from a foreign land. And I had what we used to call illegal substance on my person. I didn't mean to have it. It was just so cheap over there, I couldn't help it. No. And everything was fine until I got on the plane, and the plane took off, and I suddenly realized, wait a minute, I can't get out of this plane. And not only that, I was sitting in the no-smoking section. So I knew I was in trouble. And I had what we used to call inspiration, but we don't call it that today. We call it, I don't know, paranoia or something like that. And back then, we used to call feelings like that inspiration, remember? And not only that, I was feeling, it was more than, it was like revelation, because I could see stuff. I was looking out the window of my plane, and I could see that man smelling my plane. And I was 1,000 miles away from America. But I could see him as plain as day. And so, in a desperate fit of inspiration, not knowing what else to do, I ate it. And there I was. Sitting in seat 36C, D, E, and F. I was floating around the plane. But it was okay, because I knew I had powers. I could feel the powers coming into my being. As a matter of fact, I saved everybody's life one time. Because it's true, the plane was going down. And I just put my hand up, I thought, up. And that plane went, I saved everybody. I didn't even have to say nothing. They all knew it was me that saved them. They was all looking at me. I remember when the plane landed, because the time tunnel come to meet me. I remember it was attached to the building, and it came out like that, and attached itself on the plane. And people were disappearing into the time tunnel. And I thought, boy, these people are stupid. I was the last one on the plane. And I finally was escorted personally into the time tunnel. I remember I was about halfway through the time tunnel when all of a sudden, standing right in front of me in the time tunnel, standing right in front of me was the same man that I had seen in my revelation smelling my plane 1,000 miles away was now standing right in front of me in the time tunnel, and he had a look in his eye that said, I know you ate it. But it was okay, because I had a look in my eye too that said, yep.
From London, from over the pole, flying in a big airliner, chicken flying everywhere around the plane. Could we ever feel much finer? Coming into Los Angeles, bringing in a couple of keys. Don't touch my bags if you please, Mr. Customs Man. There's a man with his ticket to Mexico. No, it couldn't look much stranger. Walking in New Orleans with his things and all, smiling, said it was the Lone Ranger. Coming into Los Angeles, bringing in a couple of keys. Don't touch my bags if you please, Mr. Customs Man.
Go ahead, Eddie.
Simple and loving.
to right bed, trying to come to conclusions, seeing reflections from rose-colored heads, ignoring the states of illusion. Drunk in a world of material wealth, no one can notice you falling. Fantasy flights once good for your health, now make you deaf to your calling. And all along the prophet groans with words as yet unseen. Who will wake when the master returns? Who will be lost in that?
Folks out there, we've had a great show tonight, but let me finish off this night with one of my favorite songs. I know there's folks standing around back there, so why don't you come out here and help me sing this song. This has been one of the nicest times I ever spent on TV. And mostly because it's been with some of my bestest and oldest friends in my whole life. So I want to thank everybody. Thank you, Pete Seeger. Thank you, Jerry Jeff Walker. Thank you, David Bromberg. Thank you, Bonnie Raitt. Oh, this has been fun. Thanks, Austin, Texas, for having us down here to do this show. And thank you everybody out there who's watching this tonight that's helped us get by, helped me get by, well, more than 25 years of doing this. So I love you, I mean it. Have fun. Shall I be walked in to the sky on flowery beds of ease, while others strive to win the prize and sail